Nobody knew where he came from. They only knew he came in. Slowly he walked to the end of the bar and he ordered up one slug of gin. Well, I could see that he wasn't a large man. I could tell that he wasn't too tall. I judged him to be about 5'3", and his voice was a soft Texas drawl. Said he was needing some wages, for he could ride for the West. Said he could do most all kinds of work, said he could ride with the best. There in his blue eyes was sadness, comes from the need of a friend. And though he tried, he still couldn't hide the loneliness there deep within. Said he would work through the winter for 30 a month and his board. Started to say where he might land a job when a fellow walked in through the door. I could see he was looking for trouble by the way that he came stomping in. He told me to leave Shorty there by himself, come down and wait on a man. The eyes of the little man narrowed, smile disappeared from his face. Gone was the friendliness that I had seen, and a wild look of hate took its place. But the big one continued to mock him, and he told me that I had better go. Find him a couple of glasses of milk, then maybe Shorty would grow. When the little man spoke, there was stillness. He made sure that everyone heard. Slowly he stepped away from the bar, and I still remember these words. Oh, it's plain that you're looking for trouble. Trouble's what I try to shun. If that's what you want, then that's what you'll get. Cowboy, we're both packing guns. His hand was already positioned, his feet wide apart on the floor. I hadn't noticed, but there on his hip was a short barrel bad 44. It was plain he was ready and waiting. He leaned a bit forward and said, when you call me Shorty, say, mister, my friend, maybe you'd rather be dead. In the room was a terrible silence as the big one stepped out on the floor. All drinking stopped and the tick of the clock said death would wait 10 seconds more. Oh, he cursed once or twice in a whisper, and he said with a snarl on his lips, nobody's mister to me, little man. And he grabbed for the gun on his hip. But the little man's hand was like lightning. The bad 44 was the same. 44 spoke and it sent lead and smoke and 17 inches of flame. Oh, the big one had never cleared leather, beaten before he could starve. A little round hole had appeared on his shirt. The bullet went clear through his heart. The little man stood there a moment, then holstered that bad 44. It's always this way, so I never stay. Slowly he walked out the door. Nobody knew where he came from. They won't forget he came by. They won't forget how a 44 gun one night made the difference in size. As for me, I'll remember the sadness that shone in the eyes of the man. If we meet someday, you can bet I will say that it's me, Mr. Shorty, your friend.
Oh, me. Goodbye. That's all my friends. That is all she wrote.